Welcome back to the Rope Access channel. In this video, I will show you how to aid climb with a casualty. Let's go. But the situation is, we were doing a job. We have access on this side, aid climb, do some work here, but something happens and I need to get my casualty back over this way. Multiple ways to do this. Let's say we are as unprepared as possible, but still a little bit prepared, because I'm going to use two grillons for my casualty to move him about. It's a fairly easy technique. It's just a lot of work. So first I need to do is get over to my casualty. And while I do that, you can like this video and subscribe to the channel and hit that notification bell to always be updated when I release a new video. If you subscribe, that will really help the channel out, because bigger numbers means better deals with manufacturers. So I can try and test out new gear and new materials, like this CMC harness I'm trying right now. I'm working on the Edelrid Megawatt review. It's all fun things, so I can get you guys better content. All right. On with the rescue. When we plan an aid climb job where I work, usually that means we climb around in grillons. Exactly for this reason, because you will see the rescue is really, really easy to do. If you climb the old-fashioned way, meaning cowtail and a chest descender, or maybe you have cowtails with the bull's nose where you go into, or you use something like a short connection, a rescue set you're suspended in, then the rescue is going to be a little bit more involved, meaning you have to lift the casualty up a little bit, like in a crawl or a sender rescue, and then lower them down. I made a video about that. You can watch it here, rescue from aid climb, and you could also look up the rescue from ascenders, or the chest ascender rescue from the crawl. I forgot the name. I'll put it on the screen up there again, so two videos for you to watch. And in those, I use very basic and minimal techniques to lift the casualty up and out of its chest ascender. But for now, the rescue is going to be really easy, because I can just lower him out. But a lot of people tend to, right now, put the casualty on themselves and start aid climbing back. So I need to move a two-person weight. No matter how I do it, I need to move a two-person weight, but I'd rather move two persons separately instead of two persons at the same time. What I'm going to do is I'm going to add another grillon. That was my very good preparation, because we always aid climb with grillons. I should have at least a spare grillon to perform a rescue like this if it's necessary. Or I could put myself in a little bit of a less good position and use my own grillon for the casualty, and me going into the short connection in this and aid climb in that. But we like to be rescuable. If you want to know how to do this quick, dirty and easy, store your grillon. I will be making a video about that, and if it's out, you can watch it up here. If not, you're gonna have to wait a few weeks maybe. First things first, I will put him on the inside over here. And one of the challenges of doing these things is I need to focus that everything is towards the camera. Otherwise I'd be aid climbing like this, and that would not look that good. All right, so this is would be the bare minimum, but I am in a luxury situation that I have a roll clip with me. And the roll clip is just a snapper with a little pulley in it, which will make my life quite a lot easier. Now that I'm set up, my casualty is on three points of attachment, because I have one, two, and three. So I can take out the furthest one. And I will put that, for now, I will put that here on this side, and I will just be performing a regular aid climb, but sort of skipping steps. So now he needs to go this way. That means I'm going to be moving out of the way first. So a step up, step over, I pull him towards me. There's of course again various ways you can do this, but a lot of people lift and keep them high. I just go like 1, 2, 3 steps down and then I lift them back up again. So all I need to do now is lower out the grillon. It's just a one person load, so nothing special. Make it a bit longer. Move this one to my anchor point. I will move this as well, just so that he stays orientated in the right direction. Taking a little bit of slack. So he's back on 3 points. He's got 2 grillons and 3rd as a cowtail. And I will take the cowtail and put it here. He's back onto 2 points. I will move myself. So I am in 2 points. I need to make 3. And this is actually the way I 8 climb. Right now I am talking to you guys to explain it, but usually, especially on assessment day, I talk aloud. Well, not as loud as this maybe, but I talk. I talk myself through it, I count points, I go slow, take your time. There is no rush in assessments. In real life, it might be a little bit different, but then again, we already have one casualty and my safety is more important than this guy, all right? So we only already have one problem, let's keep it at that. So take it, move slow and controlled. Slow is smooth and smooth is fast. Okay, back to counting, 1, 2, 3, I can move one of my cowtails. And I will rope management that on this side. And then I will move myself again on 1 and 2. Sit back down. I will lower the casualty into, well, maybe I can pull him in, swing him a little bit. So this doesn't cost me that much strength or force or power. I lower him down. So he's in 2 points, suspended in this one. I will move this grillon and put it in this, not this side, in between. It should be better. I will move this one to the other side as well, just to get proper rope management and orientation towards you guys. So this is basically it. You just keep doing this, and I haven't even had to lift yet, right? So I'm almost there. I will show you how I can use the roll clip to lift him up a little bit. This could also be a carabiner. All we want is just a redirect. And right now I do have a pontan, but let me show you how you can do it without the pontan. I get a rope clamp. This is my Jumar or my hand descender. We always have that on our harness. I put it on this side. I put it on that side. I take my foot loop. I double it up. Clip it in. And now I lower this a little bit. Like so, put my foot in. And if I stand up now, this is basically the same as the technique I showed you in this video, the RATS, the rapid ascent descent system. Because if I stand up here, I will lift him up to me. So let me reset it. I will lift him up a bit more, move this up, I hope it's visible. So I'm standing in my doubled up foot loop. And I stand up fully, nothing sort of happens, and now I can just lift him up. Same as the counterbalance technique, and he's up. So by doing this motion, I can do an 8 climb for as long as it takes. It doesn't really take me that much strength. I can do lower, maybe 5 or 6 steps before I have to do one lift. Or you could do a little lift every single time, but I think it's quicker to only do this like once every 3 or 4 or 5 steps, depending on this distance. All right, I will continue to the ropes and then we will go down. So I take off my hand descender. I put the foot loop back. Rope management cowtail is on this side. I will put it. And now before I continue, I will manage the ropes a little bit because it got a little bit sloppy and we always take time to adjust it and make it neat. And while I do that, again, give the video a thumbs up. Subscribe to the channel. Hit that notification bell to always be notified. That really helps out the channel. Leave a comment what you think of this technique. And if you really want to support the channel, you can head over to Patreon. Link will be in the description. And if you do that and sign up, then every video I make, you buy me a little cup of coffee. That's basically it. I don't charge for all the videos, but I do charge for the educational ones, but some of the updates I don't charge for. So I got myself into a little bit of a pickle because I was lifting him this way, but I forgot this cowtail, and it's right now a little bit of under tension, but let's see if I can move my leg that way and give it a little pull. If that's enough, one, two. Yep. So all I did was raise my knee underneath here and just a little pull. It didn't cost that much strength at all. I can take the foot his cowtail, put it here. I'm back on 3 points. We count one. This is mine. Three. One, three. One, two, and three. I can take this cowtail and move it out of the way. Rope management, that stuff again. Here we go on this side, and I will stand up here. So I will put it here for now. Get my foot back into the foot loop, and then I'm ready to move again. So you can do this with minimal gear. When I train and climb around, I usually have a Pantene, and I often have that with me on the job as well. I never need my own gear. I usually use company's gear, but there's little things that I do bring that are my own. All right, let's continue with this. Make this into 3 points again. One, two, three. I will move this cowtail to make it a bit clearer. Foot loop out of the way. Here we go. I will move this Grillon. Take it out here. Manage the ropes, and again, this is not a necessary move, but now I'm making sure that the dummy stays orientated in the proper direction. Give it a little bit of pull. I count points. One, two. He's in two grillons. Both are on tension. I can undo his cowtail. Move it here. Give him a little bit of pull. Lower the casualty out. And we're almost at the final step, so I am going to get out of my system into the ropes. First things first, the backup device. Backup device goes on. Second step is descender, or megawatt in this case, which is a descender, of course. All right, so I'm on 2 points over here. I can start cleaning up. And first order of business, get this foot free. And I've been having conversations during the last few courses with people going upgrading or getting confused. And every single time they have to do this, what I'm doing right now, the rope management, that they get insecure, I'm making mistakes, or it doesn't look good. No, taking time to do your rope management properly shows that you're conscious of what you're doing. Nobody will judge you because you take a few minutes or a few seconds or whatever time to make sure that everything is good, nice, neat, controlled, that you know what is going on. All right, next step is get the dummy onto me. So I will get the rescue set, put it on the dummy, and I will make one more step to this side. I can take one cowtail from the dummy out, then he will be on 2 points. And I take the cowtail because I can make this one longer. Next, I take the short connection, manage those ropes, see where I want it to go. Okay. I take my cowtail, which I don't need anymore right now because I'm already in two ropes. I connect my cowtail to the top D-ring or the sternal D-ring. Then I will take my rescue set or short connection to the same point. Lock all the carabiners, 1, 2, and 3. And now I can lower him out because he's on 2 points to me. So that's 1. Leave that. And I will lower him in between me. Hang on. There's 1 rope in between us. That's it. Lower him on to me. Alright, so he's almost into me. Now I'll go for my last little bit. I'm out of my own Grillon. Fully suspended in the megawatt. Clean up some stuff, make the rope management good again. Lower further in the Grillon. There you go. I've got my dummy. Little Miss Ruth Lee. Get the foot loop out. And also manage that ASAP, that dropped down a little bit. Again, we want to monitor it. It doesn't really matter if it happens every now and then, just as long as you show that you are conscious of it and you move with it. So I need an extra carabiner, which I don't have a dedicated one for now. I will use this one over here. Okay. Rope management again. I know I have my back towards you guys. Here we go. Oh, one more thing I would like to say about this video. I'm filming this at Industrieel Klimmen. Beautiful training facility, as you can see, close to Amsterdam in the Netherlands. I teach the IRATA courses here. The whole company provides any other training you want. It could be GWO, basic working at high, tower working, anything you want. There's a beautiful web shop next door. Well, actually, there's a new store that moved in Amuiden. You can check out the website. Link will be in the description. And if you use my code, you get a little bit of a discount, which is really good. And you support the channel. So if you're looking for new gear, you know where to find it. All right, I have my friction point in. My ASAP is running. I open up the megawatt, make my extra friction, and I go down slowly and controlled.